Which bank is bringing you the following program? Australia's leading home loan bank, Commonwealth Bank.
Good to have your company for today's match in the Commonwealth Bank Cup and the promise of a fiercely contested local derby. It's St Paul's College of Manly against St Augustine's College. We'll have a look at the fact sheets first of all. St Paul's College, they have been the standout school in the Manly district for any number of years. In fact, way back in 1980, they reached the semi-finals of the Commonwealth Bank Cup, and their opponent, St Augustine's, well, the college is celebrating its 40th year anniversary in 1996. So I guess a win today would kick off celebrations. And back on deck in commentary with me today is Steve Roach. This is the sort of match you really look forward to.
Oh, this will be a beauty. It's been a tremendous grounding for the senior club, Manly Warringah. Any number of these players that have played for both these schools have gone on to play grade for Manly.
And one player in particular has caught your eye on the St Augustine side.
Yeah, outstanding young centre three-quarter, Scott Robinson. He's in the SG ball side for Manly. Only 16 years of age. He's a real talent.
So Scott Robertson, the player to watch, and this is his side, St Augustine's, and plenty of their schoolmates here to watch them and cheer them on. Led out by their fullback. In fact, he's been switched to lock, David Clark, wearing the number one jumper. And plenty expected of St Augustine's College in today's match. There's their lineup, a couple of late changes. Aaron Zarb comes into the forward pack in 16. John Paul Murphy playing fullback. And as I mentioned, Clark, he's shifted into lock. He is the captain. Les Bobbis is the coach. And St Paul's College in the red and black likewise. Plenty of support from their school as well. This is the local derby. This is what we expected. And St Paul's College, they've won the local schools competition for something like the last 6 or 7 years. They're captained today by John Smithers, big front rower. And their lineup as selected, their coach is Steve Callow. Brett Lynch is today's referee. And we're now underway with Chad Randall. The St Paul's College side running from right to left. He has goal-kicking duties for the day. And St Augustine's from outside their own 20. John Paul Murphy taken high in the first tackle of the day, and referee Lynch called into the action.
Yes, a poor tackle there from Craig Redfern. For St Paul's, a high tackle. Coming there a little bit late. See it again here. Swinging arm above. He was lucky to get off with just a caution.
Craig Redfern was the tackler. Player penalised, and everyone on the St Augustine side of the field was saying off. Everyone on the St Paul's College side of the ground, which is the eastern side, saying keep him there. And now hitting the ball up is George Marrero, and some vigorous defence came from the two front rowers, Smithers and also Eckford. So both teams fired up, looking to do their schools proud. And this is St Augustine's in possession. This is Chris Corbett, 5 metres inside his own half. And a few scores to settle as far as St Augustine's are concerned. It's been a while since they've knocked off St Paul's College. Plenty of mail about to suggest that this is going to be their year. So just inside St Paul's College half and kicking early in the count, or at least before the last, going back here for Adam Martin and over the sideline. So pretty handy set of six from the St Augustine's players. And they get a scrum now 12 metres out from the St Paul's line.
Yeah, urgent start from both sides. A good set of six there, as you already mentioned. And Nugent, a kick on the end of it. Good play there from the St Paul's winger.
This one, James Mitchell working the scrums, only a 15-year-old. It's a fairly young side right across the board, St Paul's, in terms of schoolboy football. There's a number of 15-year-olds in the lineup. So they're in that rebuilding stage, that cycle. A loose ball there, it's play on. Good call from referee Lynch. St Paul's with the ball in front of their own post, 10 metres out from the line. They work a left side play this time with O'Hagan, and he's met by a welcoming committee there of O'Toole and Corbett, and pushed sideways in the tackle. So St Paul's under a little bit of pressure here, as that's the better hit up, gets them over the 20. That one came from Smithers. St Augustine's defence isn't really missing the mark. That time Anthony Anastasio came out of the line and certainly connected. This kick comes away from Randall. Good pressure from the chasers. Sits up nicely for John Paul Murphy from the back, but the chasers there from St Paul's. Oh, they're in 4 and 5.
Yeah, tremendous chase there from the young halfback Mitchell. A good tackle there. It was a good run back from Murphy. A little Mitchell cut him down.
Now with the ball, the captain Clark. His versatility, being able to switch from fullback to lock. Last minute notice, as Anastasio was allowed to run a fair way there by the St. Paul's defence. They're in no hurry to lock him up. Now it's fed across the line. Nugent, and combining with his 5'8" O'Toole, straightening up the attack. 25 metres out from the line was Joel Mason. Last tackle for St. Augustine's with Nugent. He kicks a grubber kick, and I tell you what, that's a handy take. He's dropped it now. It's not so handy. Handy for St. Augustine's, that's what it is. Tackle count restarts. 10 metres out from the line, the ball with Damon Hills. He's wrapped up and pushed back to that 10-metre line. O'Hagan was the tackler. St. Augustine's threatening points now as Corbett lumbers forward, 5 metres out from the St. Paul's line. Well spread out to the right-hand side. Nugent showing the ball now as O'Toole. He brings the winger into the play, Marrero. There's plenty of him. He slips the ball to Clark. Clark steps inside one and scores for St. Augustine's. Oh, exactly the start they wanted.
Oh, tremendous play there. Good defence there from St. Paul's to try and hold them out. They made the extra man coming in, David Clark. Man from the wing, Monero, came in to make the extra man. Beautiful set play here. A lot of inside passing. There's the ball, that's a money ball. They've got the three-man overlap. And there he is, that man, Clark, the captain. Could have easily give the ball on the outside to Mosley. But a good try there to St. Augustine's.
John Paul Murphy with a conversion attempt, just wide of the posts. It's St. Augustine's. They like the way they've started. It's 4-0.
Stay behind, fellas. Wait,
Chad Rundle, second kickoff for the match for St. Paul's College. And a bouncing ball creating some problems. It's the try scorer Clark who comes up with it. He can't beat a man, so that kickoff worked well for St. Paul's. Craig Redfern ended up with a tackle, and that was better than his first attempt to start the game.
Yeah, just a quick hello to Matthew O'Keefe for St. Paul's. Broke his ankle last week. We're all thinking of you. Hope you're better soon.
That's from his teammates, so as yet they're looking for points. Maybe by the end of the match they will have put a smile on the young fella's face as Corbett takes them on for St. Augustine's, and the head rocks back as there was three defenders there.
Well, he mightn't have much leg speed, Corbett, but he's been involved in the game early. Four hit-ups for him already. Here's an intercept.
Intercept comes the way of McIntosh. It was fumbled by Robertson, and McIntosh will sprint away to score a try against the run of play. And up go the St. Paul's supporters. Four all St. Paul's and St. Augustine's.
Well, I'm not a great believer in spreading the ball from your side third. If you cut the field into thirds, trying to spread the ball the long side, there's plenty of defence there. They're using the up and in there. Beautifully positioned there from McIntosh. And an easy sprint to the line for this young fellow. Plenty of speed there, outpaces the cover defence. And that's a good try to St. Paul's to hit straight back.
Chad Randall then with a conversion attempt. Another player to compete with the Manly SG Ball side, and he can strike a ball as well.
In relation to Terry Randall?
I don't think so, but St. Paul's are in front by two. St. Paul's 6, St. Augustine's College 4.
Today at 4, West's take on the Sydney City Roosters on 9.
How many of these banks help you save by letting you pay extra off your home loan, yet give you access to that money again if you want it?
It's very best when Telstra brings you the event of the year, the Logies, 8:30 Sunday on 9.
St. Augustine's a little rattled after conceding that try. They were still in celebration mode after getting their own four-pointer. And the ball now with Brendan Pickard. Keeping the ball with a boot and gets it over the 20 for St. Paul's College. So, bit of feeling, bit of atmosphere too with the match. With good numbers turning up to support their schools, and it's certainly got the players all fired up as Joel Eckford was trapped around the leg there just outside his own 30. St. Paul's in front by 6 points to 4. Big hit over the top. Well, that came from Aaron Zarr.
And that'll bring the crowds back.
Zarb in the starting lineup despite wearing jumper 16.
That's the last tackle. I'll tell you what St. Augustine's are doing well. Chasing from marker, putting pressure on the St. Paul's runners. There's a charge down.
And referee has ruled the tackle count restart. Then they've copped it up in a good tackle from Ben Mosley for St. Augustine's. That forced the turnover, and he goes up. Can he run the ball as well? He's taken nicely around the ankles by Pickard. But St. Augustine's on the attack outside the 30. Good game of football, this one. Nice pass there from the 5'8" O'Toole. And into the line came Murphy. Now up to the 20. Dummy half is Jean-Paul Hobbs. And this time for the halfback, it's Nugent. And they're now 10 metres out from the line. All the time edging a little closer with Anastasio. Well, one defender came rattling out the back. That was Smithers. And he's no midget. It's with Nugent again. The kick comes off the legs, fielded there by Hobbs. No restarting of the tackle count. It's the last end for St. Augustine's. 10 metres out from the line. Nugent, it comes off the arms of one and then dropped by Ben Mosley. We've seen some bomb tries. You won't get a better one than that.
Well, this is a sensational game. Both sides playing very well. The thing I like about St. Augustine's there, ability to play the ball quick. We see the ball bounce out. It was a give me to Mosley. Could have scored an easy try there, knocked it forward. Unfortunate for St. Augustine's, but the fortunate thing is that they'll get the football back from a line dropout.
Paul Ben Mosley. Yep. He'll be hurting after that one. That was an absolute gift. There's Joel Mason. He steps, he runs into the back of his hooker, Hobbs, and is tackled 15 metres out from the St. Paul's line. First of six for them. Hobbs to the left side of the ruck with Damon Hills. And Hills puts on a bit of a fend, and now a wrestling match gets him a little closer to the sideline as McIntosh had to come in from his wing with Zarb now. Plenty of Aaron Zarb. He offloaded a knock-on ruled there by the referee for David Clark.
Well, you can't really blame the young fellow there, young Zarb. Got the flick pass to the back. The players have got to learn to support players with the ability to flick the ball out the back door. Tremendous attacking weapon there. He's just taking the pressure off St. Paul's. Good shove here from...
Could be a chance missed as far as St. Augustine's are concerned, as James Mitchell was hit hard in that tackle. And St. Paul's now would be happy, I think, with just a settling set of six as Pickard gets it up over the 30. They lead by 6-4. Out of dummy half for the first time today goes Trinder, and he runs into a bear hug of a tackle from David Clark.
Yeah, that's a beautiful front-on tackle there from Clark. Move from the fullback position to lock. Geez, they're defending well, this young side. Put the big men on the ground, that's a problem at the moment.
Gone on halfway.
Try and put something on the blind.
Randall picks up his centre, Nathan Arnold, who tried to hurdle his way back in field. Fifth tackle for St. Paul's. The kick will come this time from Randall. I thought for a moment it was going to be the midfield bomb, and he ended up going a little too deep. And John Paul Murphy looks particularly safe at the back, and he can run the football too. He's beaten three and then a four.
Can he? What? Beautiful run there from the young fellow Murphy. Had a mighty game early.
St. Augustine's play settles down again with Goddard. And he backs his way in to the defence. He'll take on two and three every time, Goddard. Now with Clark, and nice step two from the captain. He unloads a great ball to Joel Mason, and Mason looks an absolute speedster. 50 metres covered in the blink of an eye. That is an exceptional try.
Well, what about that for a bit of football from the captain? David Clark beautifully positioned himself. Little step in his play. Here's the run back here from Paul Murphy. He just set the play up for the set of six. Beautiful evasive running from him. Just took a bit of an ankle tap by Pitchard to put him down. Look at this, little right foot step, gets in between two players. That's a magic pass. You won't see any better than that. Have a look at the speed of this kid, Mason.
And they've certainly backed that up. Joel Mason, great try. And converted now by Murphy. So St. Augustine's back on top in what is a very, very good game of football. 10 points to 6.
Stay behind him, fellas. Wait for it. Hold back.
Well, it's back to the turn now with St. Paul's College. Can they hit back after that try from St. Augustine's?
And a credit to both teams too, although it's been very physical. Only one penalty in this game so far.
We'll talk about the two local schools, St. Augustine's. They're homed, in fact, right opposite Brookvale. Here's that big man from the left wing, George Marrero, who took on 3 and 4 and made 15 metres.
It's Gianolumo.
He's the Steve Roach winger. As now Goddard goes forward, and a good offload from Goddard. Nice pass.
Yeah, there's a beautiful play from the little hooker, Jean-Paul Hobbs. Beautiful play from him in the middle of the ruck.
I love it when you turn on the French. As now Robertson steps for St. Augustine's. He doesn't pass. Murphy was unmarked. Now he does, but it's a little too late. Zarb is tackled 8 metres out from the line.
If they go to the left, they'll score here.
Well, the dummy half is there. Jean-Paul Hobbs. No way. They come to the right with Nugent. He draws in a couple, then passes, and the second rower, Damon Hills, has crashed over. It's an onslaught now on St Paul's, and they can't come up with the answers. Two quick tries to Zane Augustine.
Yeah, you can just put that down, a quick play of the ball. St Paul's defensive line was scrambling, got caught in a bunch. If you have a look there, there's any number of players there. They just shipped the ball on the blind side. Beautiful little pass to Damon Hills, and he just stretches over, too tall. And a good try to St Augustine. Geez, their play of the ball, Andrew, has been outstanding. A little dummy on the inside, quick hands there. And this young fellow has been very impressive. Damon Hills.
Another shot for John Paul Murphy, the fullback. This one wide of the posts. So one from three for him. And St Augustine's leads St Paul's 14 points to 6.
Stay back, fellas. Wait for him.
St Paul's College back underway. Watching the battle of St Augustine's and St Paul's. And St Augustine's. One of their replacement players on the field.
Well, what St Paul's have got to do is handle the ball when they do get it. Just complete their set of six. They've been starved of the football again. There's a beautiful ball from Hills.
And aren't the offloads starting to happen for St Augustine's? They've got some skills, and St Paul's aren't putting the man to ground right now, and it's getting to that dangerous stage. That scoreline blowing out a little as far as St Paul's are concerned at 14-6. Just inside their own half now, St Augustine's. Jean-Paul Hobbs away now for Nugent. Short pass for Zarb. Well, the work rate of this bloke is very good.
He's been great, hasn't he, in this first half? A number of players have played well. There's the kick. Very well directed there, straight down the throat of Andrew Day. Good positioning from the young fellow. Let's see what St Paul's can do now. They get through a full set of six tackles. Too many walkers so far.
Their one try has been intercept for St Paul's. Let's see if they can create some attacking play from their own half. The stepping through the tackle there was Pickard. Taken nicely by Damon Hills. They're 10 metres inside their own half, and replacements left, right and centre in this match. Tuafua is now on for St Paul's. He's the man playing it. To the right side of the ruck they go, and some quick hands from Mitchell, and they make good ground on this set play.
And a beautiful tackle over the top from Clark again. Tremendous defensive player. Good kick put in there. That was a good set of six. Hope this ball doesn't go dead. Plenty of pressure coming through.
Well, the chase has come from Arnold, and he traps it.
Yeah, great chase there from Arnold. He's the only bloke that did chase the football. John Paul Murphy thought the ball was going to go dead, and then he had to play at it. Had the big job of trying to get out of his in goal. A good chase there from the young fellow, Arnold, and a great tackle.
Augustine's called upon to do some defence, a line dropout that finds 30 on the fly and then 15 on the bounce. This time they come back with McIntosh, the man who scored their try. They're 29 out from the St Augustine's line.
Well, let's hope they can score a try in the next set of six and make a game of it. It's been very entertaining so far.
It's just outside the 20 with Tuafua. Almost was able to stand in the tackle. Hills managed to drag him to ground. Edging a little closer now. Mitchell away for Randall. Nice short pass there for Smithers. He crashes through one, throws it back inside and presents an intercept for Scott Robertson.
He's just trying to push the pass a bit. He's been outstanding for St Paul's. John Smithers, a big fat rower, causing all sorts of problems on the fringe of the ruck. Tries to get that football away.
This pass there picked up by Goddard, but referee Lynch has detected a knock on.
Well, how was that a knock on? Ball went behind.
We'll give it to him then, Block.
I did. It's not a knock on.
St Paul's with another chance. If they can get this ball out of the scrum, they've got it now with Randall, and Randall away this time to Redfern. He put a half step on the line, but are equal to the assignment of making the tackle, and John Paul Murphy up on the line from that scrum, made that tackle. Nugent again, Rana Mitchell. Tackled right on the St Augustine's 20. Step there doesn't come off for Andrew Day, it develops into a stumble. That was easy for the defence. Now the ball with Tuafua, he's keen for work.
He's been good, Tuafua, since he's came on. Been involved in the hit-ups. That'll be about his fourth hit up, I'd say. He's looked over since he's been on.
Cutout ball from Randall. Finds the chest of Crawford. Crawford unloads a loose pass for Martin. who can't get a handle on it.
Yeah, Martin probably wasn't deep enough there. The idea was right. But Sapor's just giving up too much possession. When they do get the football and into the 20-metre line, they get a little bit too excited trying to force the pass.
There's a few players in both teams with rugby union experience. They scrummaged a little way that time as Randall put on a good tackle, the 5-8. There was a bit of shoulder in it on Ben Mosley. And there's an overhead ball. Now there's a chance on now for St. Augustine's with Mason. He unloads now for Marrero. This big bloke will be hard to stop. Back inside the pass. Now with Robertson. Robertson over the 20. Well, I thought we saw a great try earlier. We've just seen a better one.
Oh, that's the Volvo.
Scott Robertson scores for St. Augustine's. Locker, it's about time we updated that car.
Yes, beautiful try there from St. Augustine's. Let's give him a VM. Tremendous support play from that man there, Scott Robinson. He's the player we spoke about from their own half. Watch this overhead ball, Gene Miles style. That's a beautiful pass there. Well set up on the outside. Mario again, too hard to handle. Passes inside to Mason. That's his second handle. And there's his other centre three-quarter man, Thompson. Too much.